Good morning, Megan Larson here, back with another video. Today I am filming in my glam office room, or what is gonna be my glam office room. It's coming together really good, really quickly, but it kind of is still a mess right now, so I will definitely give you guys a tour of that when it's finished. But today I'm gonna be sharing my story with you guys, how I became a national color educator for John Paul Mitchell Systems. I've been getting some questions from a lot of you guys, some messages asking, how do you even become an educator? What's that process look like? So I'm just gonna show you guys, or not show you, tell you guys my journey and kind of tell you a little bit of how you can become an educator if that is something that you are wanting to do. So let's take it back. My mom and I have had our salon open for about 4.5 years now, maybe a little bit more than that. So we were probably about a year into opening our first salon. And so we were building clientele and, you know, trying to get things up off the ground and all that. So I heard they were having tryouts in Charlotte, North Carolina for, to become an educator for Paul Mitchell. So I was super excited, and that was something I kind of had always thought about. I always thought it was really cool that, you know, we would have educators come in our salon and teach, and I would always be so fascinated with how they did that. And probably every single one that came in our salon, I was like, so what was your story? What was your journey? I was so curious about their journey, their stories, how they became an educator. I was just so fascinated with the whole thing. And then we would go to the hair shows, and I would see the platform artists, and I'd be so fascinated with all of that and just think it was the coolest thing ever. And if I got to talk to anybody, I would be so excited. And I just wanted to know everything. How do they do it? And so we're about a year into the salon, and we heard there was tryouts in Charlotte. So I drove down to Charlotte for the day, and they basically had this whole introductory, basically come to it, see if this is really what you want to do. And then if you decide after this is, you know, what you want to do and you can do this, then we move you on to the next phase. So I went down there, we spent the whole day. There was a room full of people trying out, and we had to go around and we did some exercises, you know, getting up in front of people, talking and introducing ourselves. And then we had to talk with another person in the room that we had never met before. Excuse me, oh my goodness. I need like some more water this morning, and this sun is killing me. I'm like, this is not a good place to film, but it's okay. So anyways, we had to do different exercises because basically they were kind of watching us too to see, okay, are they outgoing? Are they gonna be able to talk in front of people when they go to other salons to teach classes, or even when they go to the hair shows and eventually, you know, up on stage? So, you know, they went through the whole process. We watched videos on the history of Paul Mitchell, how it started. We talked a little bit about all the lines they carry. And we are a Paul Mitchell focused salon, so we carry all Paul Mitchell color, all Paul Mitchell products. So we are very familiar with all the products. We know what they have, which is one of the reasons I wanted to become an educator, because I had been using the products for a while and absolutely loved the products and knew a lot about them. So, you know, they went through the process of how much you're going to be getting paid per class, and you get paid mileage, depending on how far you drive to your classes. Just little things like that. And they just told us how it would work. And, basically, you know, you get class requests sent to your email, and you can either accept them or you can deny them if you can't teach it. And then basically I think they want you to teach about 12 classes a year. So like once a month-ish, somewhere around there. So I left there, it was super exciting, but I honestly left there and I was so overwhelmed and nervous and just all the feelings. And my mom actually came with me. So she kind of wanted to just sit in on it just to see, you know, if that was something maybe she wanted to do in the future or whatever. But I left there and I felt so overwhelmed. The whole drive home, I just was really thinking about it. And it just seemed like it was going to require kind of a lot of me. And we had just opened the salon, and I really felt like that needed to be the main focus for right then in my life. So I messaged the regional director slash coordinator for our area and just said, you know, thanks for allowing me to come. I definitely want to be an educator, but I just don't feel like now is the time. So fast forward 2 years later, we really started to grow the salon. My social media started to grow like crazy. I was putting a lot of educational content, and still in the back of my mind, I knew I wanted to become an educator. And I was listening to a podcast one day, and I think it was Britt Siva, and she said, if you want to be an educator, then what's stopping you? Just start educating. So I was like, that's true. I don't have to have the title of Paul Mitchell educator or a brand educator. I can just start educating. So that's what I did. I started posting all educational content. Almost every single one of my posts was educational. Educating the hairstylist on hair color formulas, how to apply color, different foiling techniques, social media education. And it just started to blow up, and different brands started to recognize it, and Paul Mitchell definitely started to recognize it. And they reached out to me 2 years later and they said, hey, we just started a fast track program and we want to fast track you as a color educator if you are still interested. And I said, yes, I'm ready. I want to do it. Yeah, what do I need to do? Where do I need to be? Tell me. So I started that journey, and it was a newer program they started, so it took a little bit longer than normal because they had never done it before. So basically, I flew to Nashville, Tennessee, and then I had a second training, and I went to Orlando, Florida. I don't remember the order, but basically through those two trainings, plus an online training course, all those things combined, I eventually got certified and was able to become a national educator. And so after that, I had to shadow 3 classes with an already existing educator and co-teach the class with them before they sent me my huge kit of like all the colors, all the products. And actually, you guys can kind of see some of them now. I'll turn it back there. And I know it's a mess, you guys. I'm working on it. But you can see all the products, color, and there's more. Like, it's just everywhere. But anyways, it was super exciting because it was like Christmas. I came home one day from the salon and like my front porch was like filled with boxes, and I was so excited. It took me like forever just to open all the boxes and get through it. But typically, if you guys are wanting to become an educator for any brand, any company, they typically want you to be familiar with that line of products or color for about 2 years or a year. Every brand is different. Every brand is different. I know Paul Mitchell, they like you to be, or maybe it's, they would like you to be licensed for 2 years, at least 2 years. That way you get experience in the salon, you get experience with clients, working with people. And typically a brand would like you to be working with their products and color for a certain period of time before they put you in their educator program, because they really want to make sure that you're well-versed and you really know the product lines, the color lines, how they work, because you never know what's going to get asked in a color class. And there's still things that I don't know, that things come up and I'm like, let me check on that. And there's nothing wrong with that, because nobody is ever going to know everything. There are always going to be certain things that you're going to have to say, that's a great question, I don't know the answer, but let me get back to you. And then that's when you go find the answer, whether that's asking somebody or researching it for yourself, and then going back to that person and saying, I found the answer to this, it is whatever. So typically in your area, you're gonna have local sales reps that sell your products to you or your salon, or you're gonna have like local representatives of each brand. This sun is killing me, you guys. I need to get my curtains up here. Anyways, you're gonna have local representatives of the different brands, whether it's Redken, Paul Mitchell, Joico, whatever. So I would find out who those reps are and contact them, and you let them know that you're interested in becoming an educator. and they will let you know when the next tryouts are. They will let you know what you need to do to get ready and prepared to become an educator, and they can basically give you most of the information, or they will know who to contact to get the information from. So that is my story of how I became an educator, and maybe how you guys can get your foot in with the whole educator thing, or now you know who to maybe contact or get a hold of. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, if you have any video requests, I love hearing from you guys. I love giving you videos that you guys want to hear about, and that you, of things that you want to learn. So comment below for if you guys have any other video requests, or you can message me on Instagram. I'm over there at megan.lorson, and that's L-O-R-S-O-N. Also, I do have some freebies for you guys. If you go to my Instagram profile page, click my link, it'll slide up and you'll see I have a list of things that you can do to start marketing yourself when you're not busy behind the chair. This is really good for someone trying to grow their business behind the chair, and honestly, even target brands and other companies if that's your goal, if you want to become an educator or work with brands or anything like that. So if you want to sign up for that, you'll get emailed straight to your email, and it's literally a list of tangible things that you can start doing today to start growing your business, your brand. And then I also have a free captions guide. If you guys get stuck with captions, I've created a list of just some fun, quirky captions that you guys can use, or just get other ideas from. Basically, it's just a little starter caption guide, just fun, quirky ideas for your hair pictures. And I have one more free thing. So if you guys wanna go check those out, they're all yours. And I post new videos every week, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss another video. I hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.